is a life-changing message by the Reverend Sam Korankye Ankrah.
In the name of Jesus. So write this one for me. Quote. So hashtag aging wisdom, 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 wisdom. A hidden talent placed on God's altar, comma. A hidden talent placed on God's altar, comma, as a sacrifice, comma, receives divine approval. Divine approval. Divine in block letters. Divine approval to grace the world. To grace the world. If you want to understand the word grace there, you can put it to bracket to bless the world. To grace the world, to bless the world, to become beneficial to the world. You are a world affecting man and woman. You are not a local champion. You are an international champion. What is inside of you must go beyond the four walls of your village and your family house. Yes. Who is hearing what Apostle General from Kopevi is saying?
I am the one.
A hidden talent placed on God's altar, comma, as a sacrifice, comma, receives divine approval to grace the world. Continue the quote. What do you have in your hand? ? What do you have in your hand? God bless you, Reverend. You are welcome. What do you have in your hand? Close the comment and write Exodus chapter 4, verse number 2. Exodus 4, 2. E-X 4, apostrophic 2. Apostrophic 2. A hidden talent placed on God's altar as a sacrifice receives divine approval to grace the world. What do you have in your hand? Exodus 4, 2. Close the quote and send this message right now. If you don't have data, do it later. But make sure you send them to friends who will be blessed. So if you followed my ministry during this week of the past week of the altar, the first day of the week of the altar, the first night, I opened the prayer atmosphere with Exodus chapter number 4, verses number 1 to 3. Whilst I introduced this subject to ignite prayer and to stir the atmosphere for prayer, today I will not be stirring prayer. Today, I'll be stirring consciousness and I'll be stirring up your wisdom. I will shake your wisdom base and I want you to think and to meditate. I am giving you a winning formula to win. Same scriptures. So, God meets Moses, who was going to be transferred from local community to get to the international stage to affect generations. And he didn't know that that was precisely the reason God created him. All along, he has been a local champion tendering sheep, his father-in-law's sheep, goat, and animals. And God says, no, you are a nation builder. You are a foundation layer. You are a deliverer. You are a modern day Kwame Nkrumah and a modern day Nelson Mandela. That's who you are, Moses. Get out of this bush. Then God asked him, what do you have in your hand after an interrogation? And he said, a rod, just a stick, an old rod, an old stick. I've held this for many, many years. I've used it. That's what I use in tendering my sheep. That's what I use when I'm climbing the hills. That's what I use to help me gain stability when there is something on my way that can cause me to fall down. That's the stick I use in clearing the thing away. When some animals are coming my way, that's what I use in threatening them and frightening them away from me. Just a stick, a rod. God said, drop it. Drop it. Drop it. Drop it. Where? God, where? God, drop it on the altar. Lord, where is the altar? Moses, there's an altar in front of you now. Anywhere God appears to you, there is an altar there. Anywhere God appears to you, anywhere there is God's presence, there is an altar. So drop the stick on the altar. When he did, a snake jumped out of the rod, and Moses fled. And then God said to Moses, don't run away, come back, face the snake and pick it by the tail. When he picked it by the tail, the snake turned into rod. And God was saying, Moses, that is your life that I have just demonstrated to you. So the spirit in that rod, the serpentine spirit, the snake in that rod, God was telling Moses, two lives of yours are contained here. Two lives of yours are being exhibited and revealed here. Number one, I am exposing your life of arrogance and your life of pride and your life of pomposity as a result of your upbringing in the palace of Pharaoh. You know that you are an Egyptian, a Hebrew-born Egyptian. And by your adoption in the palace, you got access to education and the Egyptian language. And you got access to a certain lifestyle of eating good food. And so as a result of that, you are taking your own life into your hands. When you see two people fighting, in your own way, you judge and you kill one. Pomposity, pride, arrogance. Moses, that's what I'm revealing to you. And as long as you do not lay your life down on the altar for me, that spirit will continue to control and to rule your life and ruin your future as well. So number one, I am revealing to you the life of arrogance. You are going to drop it today. You are going to drop it here, right now. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. Today, some young man here must decide that you have had enough with the spirit of disrespect, the spirit of pride and arrogance. People don't say good things about you. You are so pompous. You are so arrogant. You don't respect anybody. Clap your hands and say, drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it. If you don't drop it, you are carrying a rod that contains a snake. And you don't know. And you don't know. Number two, Moses, there is another life in you. It is a life of the stronghold of your past. The shadows of your past. The fears of your past. They are holding you in prison. They are holding you prisoner. You can't free yourself. Lord, where are you sending me to? Lord, I'm sending you to Egypt. Lord, to go and do what? To go and deliver my people. Go and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Oh, Lord, you know that Egypt, they are looking for me already. You know I ran away from Egypt because they want to kill me. And you want me to go back there? Moses, that's why I'm revealing to you. Put the stronghold of your past on this altar. Drop it. If you don't drop it, you will continue to be a local champion in this wilderness. You are born to write history. You are born to write 5 books of the Bible. You write, you put Genesis together, you put Exodus and Leviticus and Numbers and Deuteronomy. And after that, other Bible commentators will write about you. That's who you are. You are an international star. Ah, Lord. Very soon, I'll be introducing you to a scripture. When we come to verse number 19, God said to Moses, as you go back to Egypt, the people who are looking for you to kill you, they are all dead. In other words, whilst you are sitting here, God is taking care of those that you are afraid of.
Jesus.
The things that you are so afraid of, God is taking care of them. Clap your hands and shout, yes.
Yes.
That's one of your clothing that I'm wearing. Beautiful. And when I see your handwriting, I just tell Mama Rita, I can't believe this is a product of the altar. See that? Let our King believe. Let our Are you not proud that you have sewn a garment that Apostle General is wearing to preach to the whole world? Today, by this one introduction, the whole world has seen him already. This one introduction, Powerline TV has seen him. Facebook has seen him. Millions of people have seen him. The world has seen him. Just one worship you led today, everybody has seen it. Your concert will be a success. If you are clapping and you are worshiping, you know what? God is bringing you from your hideout. God is bringing you from your hideout. God is bringing you from your hideout. Clap your hands and say, I will hide no more. Say, I will hide no more. No more. Say, I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
Hosanna. Come on. Oh. Hosanna means salvation, deliverance, salvation, deliverance, salvation, deliverance. Let our King be lifted. To this level is he's been sitting here singing. Why is he worshiping from his youth? When there is a snake in your rod, it is a hidden talent. Until you place it on the altar of sacrifice, it does not receive divine approval. That's the quote that you are just sending to people. Why are you in the choir? You are in the choir because you want to become like one of the international stars. Why are you singing? Why are you doing recording? Because you want money. No. You don't do recording because you want money. You do recordings because you want to grace generation. You want to bless generations. You see, in some other part of the world, a man of my stature, the congregation and the crowd that I pull and what I have just done, 21 days of prayer and fasting, the bishop after this would have gone for holidays. Oh, 2 weeks holidays. America, they don't joke with this, they are. But here am I today because I can't just fathom that people will gather and they want to be blessed by me, and I'm somewhere chilling. On Sunday, oh no. Can't I chill on Monday? Why Sunday? Are you clapping or you are doing something like clapping? Somebody's miracle is tied to the word of God in my mouth.
Yeah.
Somebody is somewhere sitting there going through depression because in the last 5 years, he has been doing some act that is driving him crazy. And then I'm chilling. When a man's talent is laid on the altar as a sacrifice, it receives approval, divine approval. Then that talent and that gift becomes a gift to be a blessing to the world. David came to stardom because he knew how to use the sling, and just one sling and one stone out of five, he killed the most powerful giant in his day, and then his name became noised. And David is the one we are celebrating today because he presented his gift and what he had to God for God to use to be a blessing. What are you doing? What do you have in your hand? What do you have? What are you using your beauty to do? You think God gave you the beauty to make money from men? No. God gave you that beauty to win souls into the kingdom. I remember when Mama Rita was very young and she became born again and she was glowing with fire. Anytime you met Mama Rita, Sister Rita, at that time, young student and pretty with plenty hair, and then you made advances, she will never put you off. Never. She will entertain you very well. And then before she departs with you, he says, by the way, if you like me and you are interested in me, you must like and love my Jesus first. Oh, it was a message she would let you. He said, you like me, eh? Then I want to introduce you to my Jesus. Can you come to a prayer meeting at so and so place? Some responded. Some ran away. Oh, we caught some big fishes. The beauty brought some big fishes. Because suddenly they knew that if beautiful, intelligent young girls will love Jesus and serve God, then what am I doing with myself? Not only did they use their beauty to win men into the church, they used their beauty to win other beautiful girls. Because other beautiful girls who were full of themselves and full of the snaky pride of Egypt, the snaky arrogance and pomposity of Egypt that makes them so arrogant and whatever, when they saw beautiful girls submitting their lives to the altar of Christ, they got alarmed. They said, hey, I'm behind. Oh, we want beautiful girls into our fellowship. When I was much younger, I took a portrait, a photograph that was in use at Royalhouse Chapel. Very, very popular portrait. My hair was bushy and I was wearing blue suit with a shirt, and I turned myself halfway like this, and if you look my face, you can say, yeah, we're a Bema. Jesus. Now we don't use it anymore because I've grown past it, and using it, it becomes deceptive. Because everybody knows that Apostle Jenna, now I've got bald head, and I've changed. So why are you deceiving the whole world with? You are laughing. Oh, you use your photograph now. Use it now. I prophesy to you in 40 years. Oh, In 40 years, you use this one again. If you use this one, your children will not even recognize you. So, Pastor Papa is going to preach and he's using his portrait right now in the next 35 years. His children will not even attend a meeting. His children will not attend a meeting. They say, Papa, I said, Daddy, they say you have a son somewhere who is preaching. Who is the son? We don't know the son. Oh, it's me. Daddy, it's not you. It's not you. That portrait brought girls into the church. This IBWC. There was this girl said, when he saw my pictures, also for here, you are for again. My journey so more.
Come on.
She just came and joined the church because I was handsome. And when she came, the power of God hit her. And she discovered that I was not only handsome, I was powerful.
81.
Oh, increase that clap offering because God is bringing a handsome man your way. What was Augustina? Augustina. You haven't told me the type of man you want to marry, but I know that you have described. They said, God, I want somebody like Apostle Jada, very handsome, very tall, very fair, intelligent, very. May the Lord give it to you.
Amen.
Oh. Charlie, one of the things that must not happen to you is to marry an ugly man who is having sex with you. That one is, it shouldn't happen to you. May the Lord deliver you in Jesus' name. You see, she saw into it. Oh, may the Lord grant you the desire of your heart.
Amen.
Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. This small boy went to a crusade, Jesus' crusade. People were hungry. Jesus had preached and Jesus wanted to perform a miracle. And he needed a substance to stand upon, an agent to instigate the miracle. And then this small boy, they said, Jesus, we have a small boy here who has 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He said, bring him. This boy will make history today. When the boy presented his talent and his gift and he placed it to the altar, the Lord blessed it and fed 5,000 men and he collected excess. The boy's name has become history today. Today, we pay tithes and we are giving big monies and we are building domes and big churches. Oh, do you know who inspired you to be a giver? It was a pure, poor widow who gave his widow's mite. And when Jesus Christ commended her and said, this woman has given the best, from that day, your faith was challenged and you started giving towards the work of God. You know how you are, why you started giving? You started giving because once upon a time, you heard that a certain prostitute broke an alabaster jar of ointment and poured it at the feet of Jesus and anointed Jesus. And since you heard that one, you were challenged. You said, hey, if prostitutes can serve, if prostitutes can give God, if prostitutes can lay down their lives, if prostitutes can commit their talents and their giftings to God for God to use them, what am I doing? With my first degree, what am I doing with my master's? What am I doing with my beauty? What am I doing with my eloquence? What am I doing with my intelligence? What am I doing with my energy and power? What am I doing? I challenge young people here. You think you have served God? Come on, up your game. Up your game. You haven't served enough. You haven't started, as a matter of fact. You haven't. You think you have loved Jesus enough? You haven't. Moses, what do you have in your hand? Drop it. Snake. And God said, oh, I'm only telling you the 2 lives that you have led. Your life of arrogance and pomposity from the Egyptian palace. You won't need it in the next place where I'm taking you. You won't need it there. Number 2, I am dealing with your life of prison of the past. The fear and the shadows that you have been walking in all these years. Lord, I cannot even talk. I cannot even talk. How can I lead the people? Moses, I will be your mouthpiece and I will speak through you. You speak the words that I give to you. Jesus, God told him. When you lay your life down, no weakness is above God's plan and purpose for your life. Can I say it again?
Yes, sir.
When you lay your life down and say, God, use me, every weakness becomes submerged into the plan and to the counsel. You couldn't speak, God will make you speak. You don't have money, God will put money in your hand. I didn't have money and I told God, I said, God, give me money. If you give me money, I will serve you. God gave me money. We have just finished paying the school fees of all our university students. Just finished. We wrote check without sweat. Because I don't want people to be driven home for school fees like I was. This oil dome we are building, I can tell you of a fact, we are not owing any contractor as of now in pipe bills. We paid every contractor. Today. Because God decided to put money and resources in my hand. God, another thing. The people will not believe me. They won't believe me. When I tell them I have met the God of our fathers, Abraham, and the God of our fathers, Isaac, and the God of Jacob, they say, hey, Moses, stop this. And I say, Sam, stop it. Do you know the God of Abraham? The God of Abraham prospered Abraham, and Abraham was rich in gold and sheep and cattle. Tell us, we, the Israelites here, show us what God we have. Are we not slaves here? Are we beggars here? And then, did you say Jacob? Wallah. Jacob prospered in Laban's house in a foreign land. By the time he was living, he was wealthy and rich. Show me what blessing God has blessed us here. So God, you see, these are the questions they'll be asking me. They won't believe. Moses, tell them you have met. And then when they ask what your name is, what's your name? Tell me. All the Egyptians, they have names for all their gods. The Egyptian sun god, the Egyptian river god, the Egyptian farm god, the Egyptian frog god. So every one of those 10 plagues that God visited Egypt with was a direct response and scorning of their gods. Direct scorning and spiting and confronting all the Egyptian gods, all the temporary plagues. That was the purpose. Tell them I have sent you. I have no beginning, I have no end. I am eternal. Anybody who wishes to know me but their mind will never know me. But when you lay your life and say, Lord, I surrender to you. Use me as a student. Use me as a single man, as a single woman. Use me as youth. Use me as a young person. Use my beauty. Use my money. My money is not enough, but the little, use it. Use me as a bank manager. Use me, Lord. As a young husband, as a young wife. Use me. Use me, Lord. Oh, come on, clap your hands. Today I'm not creating prayer atmosphere here. Today I'm shaking the foundations of your wisdom.
Yes, sir.
We are not praying here today. I beseech you by the mercies of God that thou present your bodies as living sacrifices. Where? To the altar. Holy. And God must accept it, which is your reasonable service unto God. I beseech you by your mercies that you lay down your life to God on the altar of mercy. I challenge you, elder. I challenge you. When you were young, you danced for the devil. You were popular for the devil. Since you came to Christ, show me what you have done for Jesus. And today I want to set you into thinking. Go go home and think and fast and pray and say, God, what can I do for you in my sisters and beyond? Let me wrap up, because I've gone beyond my time. We're supposed to be spending some 2 hours here. Let's end chapter 4, verse number 19. Let's end chapter 4, verse number 19. Now the Lord said to Moses in Midian, go, return to Egypt, for all the men who sought your life are dead. So what David was so apprehensive of, sorry, Moses was so apprehensive of and was so afraid of and had held himself in prison and hiding in his rod, he didn't know that God had even taken care of it. He didn't know. The men who are seeking you, they are dead. Your murder case, which was recorded in the books, the file is lost. It's been thrown into the archives. In fact, fire gutted the registry and the file is burnt. So they cannot trace your case, Moses. Clap your hands and say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Cancel my past.
Cancel my past.
And my fears and my weaknesses.
And my fears and my weaknesses.
I lay them on the altar.
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 And the serpentine spirit.
And the serpentine spirit.
And the spirit of snake.
And the spirit of snake.
Hiding in my rod.
Hiding in my rod.
My talent.
My talent.
My beauty.
My beauty.
My giftings.
My giftings.
My finances.
My finances.
Clap your hands and say, come out.
Come out.
Come out.
Come out.
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 I abusi ale maro nibi ale. A miracle is happening here in the house of the Lord right now. Those who are seeking your life, they are dead. Your past is erased. Your past accusation, the file is bent.
Yes.
Verse number 20. Verse number 20. Then Moses took his wife and his sons and set them on a donkey, and he returned to the land of Egypt. And Moses took the rod of God in his hand. He took the rod of God. Now, at first, the rod was the rod of Moses. The rod belonged to Moses. It was his personal rod. But after the rod had been laid at the altar, and after the snake had been cast out, after the pride and arrogance cast out, after the greed and the selfishness cast out, his fears and apprehensions cast out, his so-called ineloquence cast out, his masturbation spirit cast out, lesbianism cast out, homosexuality cast out, fornication spirit cast out, adultery cast out, sleeping with people's husbands cast out, lying tongue cast out. The rod became the rod of God. May you be described as the gift of God.
I receive it.
Your talent as the talent of God.
I receive it.
May your life belong to God.
I receive it.
A living sacrifice.
I receive it.
Holy and acceptable.
I receive it.
Which is your reasonable service.
I receive it.
Receive grace.
I receive grace.
Grace to finish.
I receive it.
Grace to serve God.
I receive it.
Grace to please God.
I receive it.
Grace to honor God.
I receive it.
Honor God with your substance.
I receive it.
With your life.
I receive it.
With your finances.
I receive it.
With whatever you have.
I receive it.
With your marriage,
I receive it.
With your children,
I receive it.
Say, my father,
my father,
my father,
my father,
help
me
to honor you, ashes, ashes. Sorry about that. It took all of us by surprise. Put the chair back. Lift up a song for me.
I surrender.
I surrender
the rod
to all,
to you.
Yeah.
Everything,
yeah. woman, young man, what are you holding on? What are you fighting God over? Do you want to be a local champion or an international champion? What do you have in your hand? Drop it at the altar. Surrender your life to Jesus.
I surrender to you.
We are finished week of the altar. The miracles are coming. The miracles are coming. But God needs your life. God needs your life. God needs you. Total surrender.
Withholding nothing.
Don't hold anything from Jesus.
Withholding nothing.
Don't hold anything from Jesus.
Withholding nothing.
Don't hold anything from Jesus.
Withholding nothing.
Say, I surrender.
I surrender all to you. Everything, everything.
The altar is hearing you. The altar is hearing. What are you holding on? Start praying. Say, Lord, I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. Oh, God has heard your tears. God has seen your tears. God has seen your tears. Son, where is son? Tall, call that tall guy for me.
So you can use me. I surrender all to you.
Somebody is getting healed right now. Deliverance is taking place right now. The rod of Moses after encounter becomes the rod of God. May your giftings and your talents be deposited before God.
I receive it.
And may your gift be for the honor of God.
Amen.
May the world grace the gift that is upon you.
Amen.
Smith, come for the anointing. Please take this once away. Kneel down. I anoint you and I reveal you to the world.
Amen.
By the promotion of the altar of your father. Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
So shall it be.
Amen.
Lift up your... Oh. Why? Who stopped my preaching today? Who stopped my preaching today? Look at verse number 21. And let us pray. Look at verse number 21. And the Lord said to Moses, when you go back to Egypt, see that you do all those wonders before Pharaoh, which I have put in your hand. The rod which produced snake now shall be the rod of miracles.
I receive it.
The rod of signs and wonders.
I receive it.
Can I prophesy to you?
Yes.
From today, Jesus, your life will not be a life of failure.
I receive it.
A life of shame.
I receive it.
A life of destruction.
I receive it.
Your life will be a life of miracles.
I receive it.
Signs and wonders.
I receive it.
I release greatness.
I receive it.
Greatness.
I receive it.
Greatness.
I receive it.
Greatness.
I receive it.
Clap your hands.
Clap your hands.
Open your mouth.
Open your mouth.
Pray.
Pray. Begin to pray right now. In the name of Jesus. That same rod in your hands. The Lord is turning it around. Hey, Marito Santa. It is turning around for your good. You are receiving the miracle. You are receiving the testimony. In the name of Jesus. Akabano Saya. Imarata Kabahaya. Ileva Saya. Ile Marundesa. Apriata. Clap your hands. Lift up your voice in prayer.
Release yourself from prison.
Yes, Lord.
Say, I will stay in the prison.
Yes,
the shadow of the past.
In the name of
Jesus. My fears.
Of my fears.
Say, I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
I'm coming out.
Break it.
Break it.
I will not be afraid.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord.
The Lord
will go with you.
Will go with you.
The Lord.
The Lord
is with me.
Is with me.
Let the young men.
Yes, Lord.
The young women.
Let the young women.
The children.
The children.
WMG.
Yes, Lord.
Young people.
Young people.
Pray.
Pray. Lift up your voice.
Hey, I feel the anointing in this place.
Jesus.
Hey, Kabosi. I saw Moses standing in front of Pharaoh. And Pharaoh was intimidating Moses to the highest. Moses, what do you say? Let my people go. Which people? Nonsense. You are born into slavery. And then God said to Moses, Moses, lift up the rod towards heaven. Kaboseke. The rod of Moses, which has now become the rod of signs and wonders. He lifted the rod to heaven, and then quickly fire and hails, brimstone started coming from heaven to the ground. The ground started cracking and burning with fire. Pharaoh stood there and he said, what is this? And Moses said, he said, when I ran away from you before, my rod was not speaking. But my rod has not been laid before God. God has turned my weaknesses into strength.
Jesus.
So if you thought God was not with me, Moses, God is with me now. And Pharaoh said, go. You can burn the whole of Egypt. You won't go. That passed. And then Moses was told that Pharaoh was calling him again. So he came. He said, sir, I hear you sent for me. He said, yes, sir. Can we negotiate now? Let the men go. The women and the children stay to guarantee your return. He said, sir, I told you, in this sacrifice, both the men and the women and the children, we are not leaving our cattle, Jesus. Our sheep.
Yes.
We are not leaving anything here. We all of us are going. Oh, may your children follow you to your
in the name of Jesus.
And may your children honor you.
I receive
like Teacher Martins.
Yes.
Around this time, Pharaoh was tired of Moses' bluff. Oh, when you meet God, you bluff. When you have encounter with God, your life turns around. Yes. The Moses who said you couldn't talk, now is challenging Pharaoh word to word, mouth to mouth, because God was speaking through him.
Yes,
the Moses who said he was afraid of Egypt, now he's standing in front of the one who could order his death without an iota of fear. Now, by this time, Moses knew that his rod was the rod of God. He lifted the rod, and then the Bible says an eastern wind blew into the land so strong that by the following day, locusts had filled the whole of the land of Egypt. They ate vegetation, trees, everything. Everything. And then Pharaoh now sends for Moses. He said, Moses, now I know that your God is God. Pray for me. And when you go, my sins be forgiven. He changed his mind. God killed the firstborn. Then face to face, Red Sea, chapter 14, verse number 16. And then God said, Moses, why are you afraid? Have you forgotten the encounter that you had with me in chapter 4? Have you forgotten that the transformation stretched for the road over the sea? And then when he stretched forth, the sea divided. Hey! Listen, I'm telling you, when you have encounter with God and you deliver your life and you surrender your life, your giftings, your talents, whatever you have, your life becomes a life of miracles, signs, and wonders.
Yes.
Clap your hands and shout and say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive
the impartation
and the grace
of power,
signs,
wonders,
miracles,
breakthroughs.
My God.
I surrender.
Clap your hands.
Pray. Lift up your voice. Wherever you are standing, it is time for welfare. Are you clapping your hand? Are you
praying?
Pray.
Surrender.
Yes, Lord.
Surrender.
Your beauty.
Your degree. Your eyes is on
the sparrow.
And your hands.
Your hands, they are for me.
Is that your prayer from the ends of the world?
From the ends of the earth
to the depths
of
my heart.
Oh
Jesus.
Your mercy and grace.
Be seen. You call me to your purpose.
You call me to your purpose.
us angels. This is the year of angels. May the Lord dispatch angels. The church is in prayer.
For your glory.
The altar is speaking for you right now.
Let your love and grace demand.
From the beginning, sing it again. Your eyes is on the sparrow.
Your eyes is on the sparrow.
May the Lord bring you visitation this week. This week, may you meditate upon this word. Everybody, I want you to record this message on your phone and listen to it over and over and over and over again. And say, Lord, use me. Use me. I can be a local champion. I cannot be hiding. I cannot be hiding in my house, my family, my village. Lord, make me like David. Make me like Samuel. Make me like Moses. Make me, oh Lord, like the young boy who brought his 5 loaves and 2 fishes. Use me like the my woman who gave a widow's mite. Use me like the prostitute who broke the alabaster jar.
For your glory, may you draw me as your love and grace demands.
Say,
yes, I will run.
Your words of grace. Run to the word. Run to the word. Run to the spirit. Come on. It's not by might. You can't do it by yourself. You can't do it until you surrender.
It is our fervent prayer that this message will have an effect on your life and will lift you to the place where you belong. For an additional copy of this and any other life-changing CD, please look up the address on your CD. Royalhouse Chapel International, touching our generation with the power of God. God richly bless you.